Hello, I'm Mrs. Charles again, back with another science activity. We're going to build a siphon using empty water bottles and straws. Here is what the siphon that we'll build today looks like. We'll add water though to see how it works. Siphons can look very different from each other, and they each do special things with water. So, what is a siphon? Well, it's a tube, and the straw is the tube in this, and it moves water from one container to another. Siphons can move water downwards or upwards. As an example, if you had a huge fish tank that needed to be emptied, you could use a siphon. You would put a tube into the fish tank and put the end of the tube lower into a bucket. And then you would take the bucket and bring it to the sink so it would be easier to empty that fish tank. So we don't have a fish tank, but we're going to show you how siphon works using this. So you'll also see the surprise, which is water seeks its own level. This is what you'll need to do the seek and find project. A ruler, two straws that are bendable, green food coloring, or you could use blue or whatever color, just don't use yellow. A push pin, a pencil, two empty water bottles. I'm using 16.9 fluid ounces, but it doesn't matter as long as they're the same size. And this one is an 8 ounce, it's a littler one, which you need. You need one bottle cap to fit the bottles and a plastic cup, pitcher filled with water, which you'll add food coloring to, a pair of scissors, a spoon to stir the water and the food coloring, a Sharpie, and a paper towel. And the last thing you'll need is a glue gun and glue. All right, I'm going to take the scissors, cut off the label of both my tall bottles. Now, I take one of the bottles, undo this, and I'm going to take my ruler and measure about 5 inches, and I'm just going to take a marker. Mark where that is. All right, there's my little mark. Now I take a push pin and just punch a little hole. Take my pencil in the same hole and go like that to make it fit about a straw size. And then I'm going to take my marker and mark around the hole just so that I can see where it is next time, because it's hard to see on these plastic bottles. Now, take your second bottle and your ruler. Measure about 2.5 inches from the bottom. Mark it with a pen or Sharpie. Make your pin prick and then put your pencil in and draw your circle around it, because it really is hard to see. Turn the bottle over exactly so that it's right on top of the other, on the other side of the bottle. Mark your 2.5 inches. There, I can see, because I marked it with a marker, where exactly it is. And then mark this hole. Okay, on my small bottle, I'm going to take off the wrapper. And I'm going to, now you'll need a mom or a dad or an adult to help you do this. You're going to glue along the bottom edge of the cup and glue it right to the upside down plastic cup. Right, like that. All right, now take your ruler, measure from the bottom of the cup about 5 inches. Make a little mark right about there. And now take your push pin, prick the hole, take your pencil, and make a hole. Now, take your 2 straws, and the long side, not the short side, you'll want to measure and find the 6-inch, which is right about here. And you want to cut your straws like this. From this point on, you will need adult help. Now, take your bottle that has holes on both sides and your bottle that has the short one, the short bottle. Here's your straw, the bendy part, the short side goes towards the tall bottle. Stick the straw through and then stick the taller end through to the short bottle. So it kind of looks like this. And you can bend this so that it won't sit flat. This is fine. Take the straw, here's the bendy part, here's the long part, here's the short part. Take the long part, put it in the hole, just like that. Take your third bottle, which has only one hole, put the short end of the straw into this hole, like that. Now, the middle bottle will not be flat until you add water. You'll need to hold the bottles so the adult can glue around both straws where they connect to the bottles. Just inspect it and make sure it looks like there's glue around the entire hole. All right, you're going to put the lid on top of the middle bottle and screw it tight. We're ready to add water. I filled my water pitcher with water and added some green food coloring. Now pour water into the tall side bottle. You're going to fill all the way up. When it fills the middle bottle, slowly keep adding water until the small bottle is filled. Now all 3 bottles are filled. The straw siphons the water from the first bottle to the second, like you were emptying a fish tank. It even siphons upwards into the smaller bottle. Now comes the fun part. Let's unscrew this middle cap and see what happens. What happened? All 3 bottles ended up having about the same water level. This shows that 2 or more containers or bodies of water, like bottles or maybe even lakes, that are connected will have water levels that match each other. That's because water seeks its own level. Well, I hope you and your family enjoyed this science project. Hopefully you learned a little about how to siphon water and the concept that water seeks its own level. See you next time for another science experiment.